Yes, I've seen a number of people say that. So I've got some white powder on you now. Starting to change.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, let's just let that do that for a minute. So, do you think that what makes you sweat is it more temperature or stress? What would do it?
Yeah, I can't say it because sometimes, even if I'm traveling, for example, on a train and I wear a grey top and I then lift my arms, I've already got sweat patches.
And it's not particularly hot.
No.
Most people who have this say it's not temperature related.
Yeah.
It will happen anyway, and particularly if you get a bit anxious or stressed.
Yeah,
or
I think you're right. Stress may be.
Adrenaline will drive it. Yeah. Now, well, yours has changed straight away without me having to do anything to you. So I can see that you're sweating right up onto your arm, high up here. And a lot down in the crease. So I actually have a pencil and mark that out. Some Botox.
Mm-hmm.
You've had Botox before, so you know what it feels like. Botox does a couple of different things. When it's being used for the face and you put it into the muscle, it blocks the transmission of the signal from the nerve to the muscle that says move, so it stops, say, your frown muscles from working. But it will disconnect the nerve from anything. So if you put it in the skin, not the muscle, which is what I'm going to do now, it disconnects the nerves from the sweat glands.
Oh.
So when the brain is abnormally telling you to sweat, the message doesn't get there. And that's how it drives the armpits.
Oh. So will I find myself sweating more somewhere else?
Everybody asks that, and in theory, yes, but because this is such a small surface area compared to the rest of your body, it's lots of tiny injections, no big deep ones.
Okay,
it's
like a face.
It's a little bit different. It would be better if I had the light on, wouldn't it? I could see. And also it amuses you.
It's not as painful as I thought it would be. It's a lot less
painful. God, it's a funny place to have it, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh,
that was
sore. Yeah, you'll feel
I think it's come back since having children, so I think I need to.
I can see a few. But generally, it's very good. That's the outside. this has the same effect as facial Botox in that it's 3 to 5 days.
Okay.
This is why I said bring some clothes that you might be ruining because the iodine gets everywhere. I don't do this again. The first time it's done, I mark you out.
Oh, really?
But you don't need to have the iodine in the future because I don't know now where you sweat from. Because some people sweat from down here.
Mm-hmm.
It was tired.
And then just once a year before you start wearing?
Yeah.
Or do people generally have it twice a year?
It depends what they're having for. If it's for work, people have it twice a year. I think in your case, once is sufficient to do for the summer.
Doctors.
I'll put the camera off now because that's all done. So was that okay?
Yes.
As bad as you thought?
No, a lot less painful than I thought it would be.
Super. Okay, let's turn the recording off.